الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين، وبعد. إن شاء الله، as my brother said yesterday, just a few minutes of reminders after each tarawih won't take much of your time, but just a small encouragement for ourselves and our brothers and our sisters, encouraging each other in this blessed month. What I wish to elaborate upon for a few minutes is taking off where our brother left off yesterday, regarding the Salaf, how the Salaf, they were keen and they would rejoice in happiness once the month of Ramadan reached them, and how they would be in Ramadan, and how they were different, their actions and their statements, from the present time of the people that are existent today. And that is for a number of reasons. Before I elaborate upon that, my brothers and sisters, Alhamdulillah, be thankful servants that we made this Ramadan. Alhamdulillah, we could have gone any time, but from Allah's wisdom, we made it. Alhamdulillah, we're alive and we entered into this blessed month of Ramadan. So how are we going to thank Allah for that ni'mah, for that blessing? For verily, ikhwan, there are individuals that died minutes before Ramadan came in, hours before Ramadan came in. But alhamdulillah, we made it. So what are we going to do? How are we going to be in this month? And this month is not easy by way of time. As our brother mentioned yesterday, Imsak is around about 3 o'clock, and opening the fast is at 9:30 in the evening. And it is difficult. But have a glimpse into the life of the Salaf and trying to take and adapt their methodology, and maybe that will ease what we are going through. I bring to you the hadith of the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, "Man sama Ramadan, whomsoever fast the month of Ramadan, imanan wahtisaban, غُفِرَ لَهُ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِهِ." That whoever fasts in the month of Ramadan, having iman, seeking the reward with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then his previous sins will be forgiven. If we truly understand this hadith, ikhwan, then it will make it easy, our fasting. That thirst that you are feeling, it will quench your thirst. That hunger that you are feeling, that it will suffice your hunger. Al-Hafidh bin Hajar, rahimullah ta'ala, mentions in Fath to explain this hadith, when he said the meaning of imanan, whoever fasts this month, having belief, imanan, he said, i'tiqad faridatu sawm, that he believes the obligation of this fast. Wa annahu al-haq, that it is the haq, it is the truth from Allah. It is Allah, Khaliquna, our Lord, that has legislated this act. We have belief in that, and we accept that that is a farida, it is a pillar from the pillars of Islam. We accept, we have it in our minds that this is from Allah. We are His slaves, and Allah has legislated that for us. And regarding wahtisaban, seeking the reward of Allah, he said that it is talab, الثواب من الله سبحانه وتعالى, that you request and you seek the reward of that fast from Allah سبحانه وتعالى. And Imam Nawawi رحمه الله تعالى likewise says some similar speech, but the part about احتسابا, seeking the reward of Allah, he said لا يقصد رؤية الناس, he does not intend with his fast to please the people, so the people can see that he has fasted, that he will receive the madh, the praise of the people. And then he also wanted to say, وَغَيْرَ ذَلِكَ مِمَّا يُخَالِفَ الْإِخْلَاصِ, or for what any other reason he may be, that will nullify his ikhlas and his sincerity. So brothers and sisters, if you know that this is from Allah, it is Allah Azza wa Jal that is legislated it upon us, and that reward that you will receive, and there are numerous rewards, of fasting, and we will mention them over the series of days inshallah, but there are numerous of rewards. But it's enough for you, my brothers and sisters, to know that Allah Azza wa Jal has singled this month out and said regarding this month that the doors of paradise, Futih la abwab al jannah, that in this month the doors of paradise are open. Wa ghulikat abwab jahannam, and the doors of the hellfire are closed. Wa sulsilat ash-shayatin, and the devils, they are chained up and locked up. Just the mere fact of that, if you understand that Allah, due to how great this month is, that the doors of paradise are open, the doors of the hellfire are closed, the devils, they are chained and locked up. In order for us to be thankful servants, to strive hard. And remember, there are a hadith mentioning man qama Ramadan, whoever stands in Ramadan, then it is the same. Sincerely, believing it is from Allah, seeking the reward from Allah, then his previous sins will be forgiven. So Ramadan, my brothers and sisters, a part of Ramadan, you have the day and you have the night. The day is for fasting, and the night is for standing in the prayer. So try to combine the two of them. Because many of us, we fast during the day, but at night, we are wasting our time. And remember, Ramadan is nihari wa fil layl, during the day and at night. And finally, ikhwan, I leave you with the statement of the Salaf, that when it was questioned to them, limada kalam al-salaf anfa' min kalamina, that why is the speech of the Salaf, why is it more beneficial than our speech? Why is more beneficial? It has more virtues. And it was said, لِأَنَّهُمْ تَكَلَّمُوا لِعِزَّ الْإِسْلَامِ, that verily when they spoke for the honor of Islam. When they acted upon something, it was for Islam's sake, for Allah's sake. أَمَّا نَحْنُ, then he mentions, نَحْنُ نَتَكَلَّمْ بِعِزَّ أَنفُسِنَا, but we speak to bring about honor to ourselves. This is the difference. So when you get into that mindset, my brothers and sisters, when you get into that mindset of it is for Allah, this blessed month and what he has by way of benefit, you don't want to waste it. And when you are in that mindset, then wallah, your fast becomes easy. The fast becomes easy. It takes away the thirst and the hunger. And this is why if you hear some of the stories in the biographies of the Salaf, how they would fast and how they were with their ibadah, they would eat little and drink little, but yet they had so much strength because of that itiqad, that belief in their mind. So be in that frame of mind, my brothers and sisters, in order for you to benefit to the maximum that we can in this blessed month. And we ask Allah Azza wa Jal that He gives us tawfiq in that manner. Ameen. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows best. أقول قولي هذا, استغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم.